Being a lab animal might actually make you less useful for experiments. Research animals tend to become obese, have weak immune systems, and are more susceptible to cancer. And that's before the experiments begin. Only 1 in 9 drugs that work on lab animals ever succeeds in human clinical trials. And labs often struggle to reproduce each other's results.
We don't treat these animals like humans. We don't give them the variety of life that people have. And some people are saying that's why these drugs are not translating to people. And so the question is the environment we house these animals in the problem?
Lab animals typically live in barren conditions. A small plastic box, few if any companions, and that's about it. And there's a reason for this. For decades, scientists thought that the smaller the number of variables, keeping variety to a minimum, the more repeatable the experiments and the stronger the results. But growing research suggests that this approach may have backfired. Some researchers are pushing to enrich the lives of the creatures in their care, and experiments are starting to show that such enrichments not only benefit animals, but science as well.
In 2000, researchers in Australia added a bunch of enrichments to mouse cages, so things like colored balls, cardboard to chew on and play with, and what they found was that these mice were much less likely to develop symptoms of a Huntington's-like disease than mice housed in much more standard barren caging.
Before this work, everyone thought Huntington's was 100% genetic. The team has gone on to show similar results in rodent models of autism, Alzheimer's, and depression.
A few years ago, researchers at Ohio State developed what the lead researcher's daughter called Disneyland for mice. And the reason she called it this was a very large mouse enclosure. And it had all these things that you don't find in a standard mouse cage. And what they found is that mice that lived in this environment were 80% less likely to develop certain cancers than mice housed in the much more standard housing.
A stimulating environment seemed to activate the mouse's hypothalamus, a region of the brain known to affect everything from mood to cancer proliferation.
There's some skepticism out there about enrichment. First of all, there's the concern about cost and resources. And researchers worry about compromising the reproducibility from experiment to experiment. Yes, maybe they'll make animals happier, but they're not going to have any big impact on the translatability of drugs that work in these types of animals to drugs that work in people.
To provide hard science on the effects of enrichment, an unusual program at the University of Michigan called REAL is determining which enrichments work and don't work for various lab animals, and then systematically exploring how research results are affected.
If we can give them companions to live with, toys to interact with, puzzles to solve, then they are going to physiologically be a lot more like wild animals rather than these, what some people think are these very kind of unnatural systems in the lab.
As the researchers dig for answers to these questions, one day, we may see lab animals in enriched conditions as a rule, rather than the exception, for both the sake of science and the animals themselves.
Mm-hmm.